Hi, it's Alan from Crashtest Security. In this video, I will tell you more about SQL injection union attacks, how they are executed, various forms of them, and prevention strategies. So let's get started. Structured query language is one of the most popular components of modern tech stacks, as it offers a simple, powerful, and expressive language for data processing. The language allows developers to create, manage, and manipulate relational databases, streamlining application data storage and access. However, albeit the benefits, there are fundamental security challenges on a SQL-based application stack. Applications that add user input to SQL statements without adequate validation are typically one of the most common targets of SQL injection union attacks. In such instances, adversaries can send malicious commands to the backend database or web server to extract classified information, perform unauthorized privileged functions, or even manipulate the server's OAuth. SQL injection is a web security vulnerability that enables attackers to manipulate an application's backend by altering the queries sent to the database. One of the most common methods of orchestrating such attacks is by inserting a malicious SQL query as input data to the vulnerable SQL application that eventually adversely affects the execution of a predefined legitimate SQL query. The attack subsequently allows hackers to compromise the integrity of the web server and gain unauthorized access to databases. An SQLis vulnerability attack also enables hackers to exploit users' information, delete table entries, gain administrative access, and/or compromise other systems interacting with the web server. The root cause of SQLis vulnerability is primarily the ability to insert SQL code into a dynamic SQL statement based on several inherent vulnerabilities, including inadequate input validation and detailed revelation in error messages. SQLis attacks are broadly categorized depending on the situation, path, and techniques. These include blind SQL injection. In this type of SQL injection, the server response does not include the results of the altered query. Database examination. This facilitates extracting information about various database operations, types, and version. Retrieving hidden data with error-based SQLis allows modifying a legitimate query to obtain additional sensitive or confidential content. Boolean-based SQL injection. This enables altering the query to change the application logic. Union-based SQLis attacks. These attacks are orchestrated to obtain information from multiple tables. What is SQL injection union? In SQL, the union operator combines the results of two or more individual queries into a distinct result set within a single row. A hacker can corrupt queries to return database records from multiple tables using the union operator in a vulnerable application. A successful union query is primarily based on satisfying two conditions. The malicious query returns the same number of columns as the original query. The data types on all columns should be compatible with each SQL query. Categorized as an in-band SQL injection technique, a SQL injection union attack extends the results of an original malicious query, enabling hackers to extract information from the database schema or fetch cross-table entries of the remote server. SQL injection union attacks are typically aimed at vulnerable applications that use the select statement to filter the data they retrieve. A single attack may involve the attacker triggering altered queries for fetching sensitive data. A successful attack primarily depends on a hacker's masquerading skills while he determines the column-level data returned by the original query. Such an attack aims to discover the compatible data type that can be accepted through the attacker's malicious query. Let us understand this better with a scenario. Assume a website darwin.com allows users to list vehicle products by size. The application uses a user-provided field size that runs the following original query to return the results to the user looking to buy a sedan, as shown in the video. The application uses a URL of the form http://darwin.com/vehicles.feep. Category equals sedan. Determining the number of columns required to perform the injection union attack. Attackers can use one of two methods to determine the number of columns present in the result of the original query. First method. In the first method, the hacker injects a series of order-by arguments while increasing the specified index of columns until the server returns an error. The series of URLs would look similar to the following. http://darwin.com/vehicles.feep. Category equals sedan order-by 1. http://darwin.com/vehicles.feep. Category equals sedan order by 2. http://darwin.com/vehicles.feep. Category equals sedan order by 3. http://darwin.com/vehicles.feep. Category equals sedan order by 4. Quick note. In the case of a string-based union-SQL injection, adding a quote and the plus sign is required to indicate the string payload. For a string payload, the first URL request shown above will look similar to the following. http://darwin.com/vehicles.feep. Category equals sedan order by plus. Assuming the database returns an unknown cause or order by number 4 is out of range error after the fourth request, the attacker infers that the number of columns is 3. In the second method, the attacker submits a series of union select statements, each specifying several null values. Malicious queries in such an instance would look similar to the code shown in the video. Once the nulls outnumber the field column index, the server returns a database error. This could also be similar to the mistakes in the first method, or a null pointer error that allows attackers to infer the number of columns. Determining the data types accepted by the columns. Since the data of interest in an injection attack is typically a string, adversaries intend to uncover one or more columns of data type string. This is achieved by including a simple string instead of a null for each column in the queries. Assuming the original query returns 4 columns, the queries to identify columns with string data would look similar to the code shown in the video. When the union is done between the string and the column, where the column also happens to be a string, the malicious query succeeds. Otherwise, the query returns a database error message. Having determined the number of columns returned by the query and establishing the data type accepted by each column, attackers can proceed with further injection attacks via text input fields. SQL injection union attack to retrieve users' confidential data. An attacker can modify the above legitimate query by appending a union select query to form a malicious query that enables him to access user credentials from the user's table. A malicious query would look similar to the code shown in the video. The attacker can submit the query as an encoded request with a URL if the application lacks adequate input validation. The attack can also be propagated through a classic injection attack with a URL. http://darwin.com/vehicles.feep. Category equals sedan plus union plus select plus username password plus from plus users. SQL injection union attack to retrieve multiple values. Attackers can also craft malicious queries to retrieve multiple values of a single column. The attack involves concatenating the information from multiple database tables into one using the symbol, as shown in the video. Quick note. Tilde performs arbitrary separation while indicates concatenation. A malicious URL would, therefore, look similar to the following. http://darwin.com/vehicles.feep. Category equals plus union plus select plus null username, password plus from plus users. Try Crashtest Security today to discover how it integrates into your development stack for efficient, automated vulnerability scanning. The trial is free. Also, subscribe to the Crashtest Security channel to get more information about the most significant web security threats, their prevention, and how to use the Crashtest Security Suite. Thank you for watching, and see you in our next video.